Spice Icon from Montreal. I'm the singer, well, the growling one, high pitch one. What's your name?
Steve.
Mario, whatever.
We'll be right back.
name's Alex. I'm one of the two singers. I'm Al, new guy, guitarist, from Boston. I said it, yeah, dude guy.
This is BS.
He goes to the bar. Yeah, basically, Al was one of the finalists, like, out of all the audition tapes we got, and Al's the man, so that's why he's here. And his shirt's purple, so, I mean, purple shirt.
It was a big thing for me, was basically joining this band. I knew I wasn't going to be, you know, I was 22 when I joined. I knew I wasn't going to be on recording until I was around 25. So it was kind of a big deal wanting to, you know, be part of writing music. I knew I couldn't do that for a couple years on a release CD, so... You know, their new material was kind of the bigger push for me. So I'm like, if I'm going to play someone else's music for that long, it's going to be something I'm really into. And after hearing the new CD, it's kind of, you know, my decision was made. I'm like, this is what I want to be doing, and I want to be part of that, you know.
I was basically on vacation visiting my ex's parents for Christmas. Went on the internet, saw Despise was looking for a guitar player. Found out about it basically on Christmas Eve day. The day before, I rushed down to Guitar Center. I had nothing with me, I was on vacation, so I bought a whole guitar rig and everything, the whole deal, and stuck my girlfriend in the room with me for pretty much the entirety of Christmas Eve day, videotaping my ass playing Despise Icon songs over and over again. And after spending the entirety of my ex's, you know, Christmas vacation trying out for Despise Icon, kind of put a lot into it, and Alex gives me this phone call that was ridiculously long, like, so, what's up, Al? What's going on, Alex? Like, so, we've been, thinking about, you know, you trying out, and, you know, after thinking about it, you know, just kept fucking going, like, Jesus Christ, I'm not the band, just say it already, what the fuck? And then he's like, all right, let's do it. Like, all right, cool.
All right, let's keep this shit moving. This next song is called Bulletproof Scales. Nothing done. No, 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 no. It's called Harvesting of the City. Don't be fucking shy. Move around.
As far as turnouts, really great. We hit it off really well in mainland Europe. That's where we actually saw a lot of our own fans coming out, whereas UK and the other side, it was us making new fans.
As far as Europe's concerned, I mean, dude, you're in a tour bus every day, no driving whatsoever. You just get to hang out, visit all these cool different cities that, I mean, that's where, I mean, I would have never had the opportunity to visit all these places if it wasn't for the fact that I'm in a death metal band, right? So.
Love is love. Love's where we would have gone. That's the point, man. I'm the singer. I'm creating a new field of slavery. Against something. This prison means a certain thing.
Wake up, have a coffee, nice espresso, and sightseeing. I'm used to drink, I never got any more, ever.
Johnny was fucking the singer from the book.
Yeah, it was like the evil twin of Steve.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were pretty much together, they were drinking buddies, and they both missed their bar, so I guess we need something. You know, getting to go sit at the Eiffel Tower, and what was that other weird thing in
France? Oh, we saw Big Ben. We saw the London Bridge, we saw the Eiffel Tower, and, you know, Oh, Austria. Where's that? We played in Salzburg.
Oh, it's
yeah, this half our group climbed like an hour and a half, 2 hours up to the top of a mountain to drink a beer in a castle. We get to the top, just bummed out. We're like, alright, this definitely is not the castle this time to see, probably the size of this room. But some old guy bought it, turned into a pub, so kind of made a trip over for a while. But...
Oh, true story. When we were in Europe, that's when we announced Al as being our new guitarist and all that. So this one time he's like at the bar, he's like, dude, you just welcomed me in the band, now you have to drink with me. And I had not drank in like 2 years, like literally not a drop. So I was like, no way, dude. So he just like shoves a shot glass in my hand. He's like, you need to do this, man. You just welcomed me in the band. So I'm like, all right, peer pressure, let's do it. And then, want another one? Yeah, sure, why not? Want another one? Okay. And then all of a sudden I get drunk like that because I'm not used to drinking.
An hour later, there's a bowl of vodka in one hand, bowl of Jaeger in the other. I'm like, what the fuck, Alex?
Yeah, it was great. I got shit-faced, but from what I can remember, it was really fun.
Alright, this next track is called The Bachelor. We'll be right back.
most memorable shows. Well, I mean, like, different shows for different reasons, right? I mean, recently we were stuck with like 2 days off in a row, which we're not used to having on tour. And so we booked like a last minute show in some guy's basement, like in his house in Thunder Bay. Ended up being like really badass, had a great time. And you know, we've played like, we've had the opportunity to play a lot of big ass venues, like, I don't know, all the Houses of Blues in the US, for instance. And you know, we've only done like 2-3 house shows in my life. And those were actually funner than some of the, you know, bigger venues we've played. And I don't know, we play like fucked up places, like pool halls and bowling alleys and
half pipes.
Skate parks. We played so many skate parks this year for some reason. I don't know why, but I enjoy it. We did a skate park in Reno. We did one in
Memphis.
Memphis. We played there twice this year. We did another one in
Edmonton. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Well, yeah, that's not a lot. That's still more than what we're used to.
Three or four times.
You know, maybe like 4 times this year in a skate park. So, just because of the locations, maybe, those are, you know, sort of stick out a bit more. As far as like the shows themselves, for me personally, Montreal, every time, yeah. It's just like,
so crazy. Our hometowns, like Montreal and Boston, Worcester.
Yeah,
those places are like sure bad for us. Like,
back home, Montreal, or anywhere in Quebec, actually. But as far as like outside of this country, Massachusetts has slowly become a second home to us, just because of all the big ass shows we played there, just because of the people around there in general are a bit more supportive than what we're used to seeing. And maybe part of it has to do with the fact that one of our guitarists is from Mass, I guess, or not even, I don't know. But Massachusetts.
Al's a rock star in Boston.
He's a cock star. And Massachusetts is probably the only place where he could get laid. I don't know what I'm saying. Never mind.
Thank you. update. Alex is driving.
Just stay outside.
Brian, the professional driver.
Yes.
What the fuck are you doing?
Am I clearing it? Isn't the exit that way?
Always the same driver.
The exit is that way.
Except guitar.
Alex is afraid of everybody's driving.
Yeah.
Alex plays way too many video games, and so he's sort of really good at driving, even though he's only been driving for a few months. I've been driving for 8 years, and he's teaching me a lot of stuff that I should do, but I sort of give him shit for that a lot, but he is right about a lot of things.
So every member of our group gives me shit when I drive. I'm really good at turning the volume up and ignoring.
No, it's mostly when he talks, when he drives and has his cell phone, talks on his phone, and all of a sudden you keep seeing the van doing.
Well, we just call it neighbors.
Not following GPS at all?
No. Alright, how's phone?
We've got our own GPS on the camera.
Love it when he's talking on the phone while driving. Such an awesome driver.
Oh, he didn't make that. He's worse than I.